It's your boy Papa Smurf, and I'm in a building right now with a great artist. You know, he's killing shit right now. I'm in here with my boy B Turn. What's up with you, man?
What's good with you, bro? Appreciate you having me on the show.
Yeah, good looking out for coming through. Sure. What you been up to lately?
Sure, bro. Working a lot. You know what I mean? Just trying to work on as much music as possible. Spending time with my daughter. You know what I mean? Just growing up. You know what I mean?
Yeah. How's that going for you?
It's cool. You know what I mean? The music's coming along. I've been definitely making more moves recently than I have in the past few years.
I've seen you've been out traveling and shit, doing shows.
Yeah, we actually just came back from Laguna and Fullerton. We did a little like mini West Coast run.
Oh, really? How was that? It was pretty cool.
Yeah, it was dope. Shout out my dude Matt Budgel. He has a little company called Groove It Global, and they basically he'll book artists from wherever, really. He kind of reaches out to artists and then books them. So we did a show. I did a show on the 8th. I headlined a show, and that was over at the Carmen Bar, and that's in Laguna.
Oh, okay.
And then
it's nice over there.
Yeah, it's a super nice area. And then just last week, me and my cousin did back-to-back shows. We did one in Fullerton at Slide Bar, which that was pretty dope. And then the next night, we did the Carmen Bar again, and we opened up for Audio Push.
Oh, okay.
And that one was lit. There was a lot of people there. Yeah, Audio Push has a great live performance. They're just, like, super on point with everything.
How are you performing now?
I mean, personally, I'm my own worst critic, you know what I mean? So I think we always kill it. Like, we always have the crowd hype, good feedback and whatnot. But, you know what I mean? After every show, I'm always like, all right, I could have done this better.
Yeah.
I could have done this better.
When was your first show? Like, a while back? You've been doing shows?
First show, damn. I'd say my first show, we probably did the first show at the Epicenter in, like, 2011 or 2012. Maybe 2012.
So you already got a lot of shows just down packed.
Yeah. We've opened for a good amount of artists. We usually try and stick to that more so than, I mean, we'll do free shows here and there, you know what I mean? Just local shows with a bunch of random artists. But I think the last show we did was like Hobson and Token and Joyner Lucas, and that was at the Observatory.
Hobson is
that was dope. Yeah. We've actually opened for Hobson and like Dizzy Wright.
Dizzy Wright is hella cool too.
Yeah, super dope. Every time they've come to San Diego in the past 4 years, we've done the show with them. So it grows, you know what I mean? It's been growing each time.
So how long you been doing music for? When did you first start, you know, thinking about rapping, like, oh, I really want to do this?
I mean, I would say, I can't really say when I started just writing or rapping, because back in like eighth grade, me and the homies would just write and just like, you know what I mean, record on the no microphone type shit, record the beat and the song at the same time.
The starter
just the most generic shit you can do. And like we rapped for a while just here and there, just more for fun, like as a hobby. And then in 2011, 2010, I actually went to NAU for a year of college in Arizona. And that's when, like, I kind of decided, like, that music was what I wanted to do. I came back to San Diego. And then, so 2011 is when, like, to me, that's when I started taking it seriously.
Yeah.
Started doing shows, started, you know what I mean, business cards, putting everything online, videos. Mm-hmm. Like, that's when I, like...
How old are you right now?
25, just turned 25 in March.
Oh, okay.
Quarter of a century.
You've been rapping for a minute, then. That's too.
Yeah.
So, I see you work with a lot of artists out here in San Diego. Yeah, that's how we got connected. You know, how is it like working with other artists out here?
I mean, it's dope, bro. There's a lot of talent in San Diego. I feel like we have a huge potential market for music, but we don't have many platforms
That's true.
Put us, you know what I mean, to put us out there, because there's so much talent. And like, you see it everywhere you look.
Everywhere.
But the other thing is, I feel like a lot of San Diego artists don't fuck with each other enough. And like, everyone's like afraid that like, oh, if they blow, I won't blow. Or if they, you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's...
People are...
You actually hit it right on the spot, though, because that's how it is. That's really how it is. A lot of people don't support each other in San Diego. Yeah. That's what we need.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, where do you... You grew up in San Diego, right?
Yeah, I was actually born right outside Chicago.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I only lived there till I was like four. Me and my mom moved out to San Diego in 1996.
Okay,
and then I've lived kind of all over. I mean, I used to live in El Cajon. That's where I first moved. North Park, San
just
Carlos.
Pretty much San Diego.
Yeah, just moving around here and there, wherever life takes me. You know what
high school you go to?
Patrick Henry.
Oh, you did?
Yes, sir. Oh. 2010. What's up? Yeah, fucking. Most good majority of my homies went to Patrick Henry, but you know what I mean? I know people from all over. I play basketball and whatnot, so
you know what I mean?
I knew people from wherever, San Diego High, Lincoln, fucking Mount Carmel, everywhere, really. Yeah, you know what I mean? Just always trying to network.
Who are you listening to right now? Who's your favorite artist?
I don't know about favorite. I can't really pick one person, but
this question hit everybody.
Yeah, that's it. It's always hard to choose. I can give you like a top five. I mean, I'll just name some off. Obviously, I fuck with Kendrick. Kendrick is fucking. Okay.
He put out some new shit too.
Bro, that song is super dope, and the video is just like, what the fuck? Really is on some next level shit.
I just seen a video today. I was like, damn, he's like super creative. It's crazy how he puts his shit together. I'm like, damn.
Yeah, that shit is dope as fuck. Yeah. But yeah, I mean, Kendrick. All of TDE, Absol is dope as fuck. Honestly, Absol and Kendrick are like some of the first artists that like put me on to the whole like Third Eye shit and just like that whole to where I really started listening and like looking shit up, and like that's a big part of my music now. So I mean, they're a big influence to me. Yeah. But I mean, let me think of people. Lupe is one of the greatest to me, bro. Mm-hmm. He's so lyricist, like no other.
This show, he's coming down too, right?
Yeah, we're actually opening up for
that show. You're doing that one too?
Yeah, that one's on April 13th at the Observatory.
I need to get some tickets in, actually.
Yeah, bro, hit me. We got me and the homie from the Ill Movement, Ill Nikki, we actually we're teaming up, and if you get a ticket from either of us, we got a party bus picking up from Firehouse in PB, taking to the show. And then after the show, either taking us to Flux or Oxford Social Club.
Okay,
and if you get a ticket from us, it's free. So
y'all doing it big then.
Get the whole little experience.
Get the tickets from him.
but that's on April 13th. That's 18 and up show. So yeah, if anyone needs tickets,
fuck with it. That's gonna be crazy.
Yeah, definitely. Fucking. I mean, there's so many more, bro. Dizzy Riot, Hobson. Fucking. It's hard to think off the top of your head when you're not on your phone. Mm. Travis Scott is dope as fuck.
Oh, I love Travis Scott. Travis Scott is hard.
J. Cole, obviously. Eminem, Big Sean. That new Big Sean album, though.
Crazy.
Yeah, that shit is dope as fuck.
So I see where your genre is going.
Yeah.
Where do you get your style from? Because you don't really rap like. No,
oh, I can't forget Kid Cudi. My fault. I forgot Kid Cudi. A lot of people don't even consider Kid Cudi as a rapper, bro. But fuck it, I'm not a rapper either. But I'm an artist.
Did you like his new album?
Yeah. Honestly, I wouldn't say it's his best album, but that's in his like top two, top three best albums for sure.
I still really haven't like gave it a listen like that. Though.
Yeah, you should peep that song with Andre 3000. Oh, I forgot Andre 3000 too. See, once you start naming off more music, then you remember the artist.
So you're more on. Those rappers, they have a message to their story and shit like that.
I fuck with that type of music more, I'd say. Like, of course, when I'm in that zone or I'm with the homies or we're going to turn up or before a show or whatever, we're listening to whatever, you know what I mean? Like, whatever's in the mood. But when I'm just by myself or I'm smoking or whatever, like, I'm listening to usually something with a message.
Just that mood music, you know, you can't listen to trap every day.
Exactly. But, you know what I mean? It's not like, I even like, sometimes I'll call out artists who make that type of music sometimes too, but like, not necessarily saying that music is bad, you know what I mean? It's just like, you know what I mean? Yeah, sometimes you gotta like, nah, bro, like, fuck that, we're right here instead.
Yeah,
like,
I know exactly what you're talking about. That's just funny. So this question is probably gonna hit you too. Strategically right now to blow up, who would you get a feature from?
You're talking about strategically to blow up?
Yeah.
Kendrick Lamar, hands down.
Okay.
Cause that, you know what I mean? Who else when you hear drops a song does every motherfucker
that's true.
Go listen to immediately? Everyone's hyped on it. Mm-hmm. Like there's other people that I would probably rather get on a song with first. Honestly, like just the type of music I make, I would pick Kid Cudi over Kendrick. I might even pick Eminem. I don't necessarily like Eminem's style as much as back in the day, but that's one of the greatest artists of all time. He's not going to be making music anymore. It's like, but if we're talking strategic wise, Kendrick Lamar, for sure.
Hella smart.
Absolutely.
Yeah, hella smart. So, you know, how is it, because, you know, your ethnicity right now isn't really too big on a hip hop point of view. Mm-hmm. Do you think it's harder for you to, you know, come up as an artist rather than the you know, average?
That's a super good question, honestly. I mean, I feel like it's a yes and no answer because there is a lot of artists who are like, who are white, who are getting big, like Jeezy and Logic and Hoodie Allen, like whoever. There's a bunch of them. But I feel like a lot of people who listen to rap or hip-hop music, if they like a certain style of music, they're not like, I mean, for instance, like gangster music. If you're listening to gangster rap, like, chances are you're not listening to my music, you know what I mean? Because it's not, they correlate, but it's not the same thing, you know what I mean? So, like, I feel like I have it easier in some ways when it comes to certain people listening to music, and then when it comes to people who are more about the hard shit, whatever, like, you know what I mean? They're not
I feel like you have an advantage, much, you know, too.
Yeah.
Because if you're good, you are good, so people are going to be like, damn, this is a white rapper right here, just killing shit. Yeah. That's crazy.
Or you want me to throw these guts real quick?
I'll
clean it up after. Damn, tobacco fucking Swishers are going up $2 tomorrow. $2.
I see you still fucking
it's
Swishers.
$3 for a two-pack. You owe me $1.50, man.
You still fuck with Swishers? That's still surprising me because a lot of people, they do not smoke Swishers. They usually get
I stopped for a while. I was just smoking joints for a while, but I don't know. It's just...
Yeah, when I first met you, when I first met you, I think we were on joints still.
Yeah, that was back in the day, bro. That was a minute ago.
But yeah, a lot of people aren't using Swishers right now. They'll get a Backwood or they'll get a Dutch. Don't matter to me though.
Whatever, whatever smokes.
You usually write and smoke too. What's your writing process? You get the lyric. You write it first, or you usually pick a beat.
I mean, sometimes I've done it a few times. That's not really like how I do it though. I'll be like in a mood. You know what I mean? To me, like when I'm creating music, I'm like creating a sound that like is a feeling, an emotion. You know what I mean? I'll search for a beat and the type of mood I'm in. Like if I want to make some turn up shit, I'll wait till I find one that I'm like, okay, like, yeah, absolutely, yeah, I can kill this. Then I'll just vibe and I'll like freestyle, I'll like think shit in my head, smoke a little bit, drink, whatever, just chill, and then that's usually how I come up with like a hook or something, write it down. And then for verses, I'll usually just write. I know a lot of people write in their phones. I'm still with the notebooks though, just because, you know what I mean? You can lose a notebook, but.
Yeah, that's how I am though. Like, I can't read that shit off my phone. Like, it's just.
I feel you. And then, who knows? If your phone breaks or something is gone, like, that's a memory I can keep. When I'm 50 years old, I can look back at my pages and keep that book. Like, I got 15 notebooks filled of shit. Like, you know what I mean? So.
A lot of people are on the iPhones now. Writing on the iPhone, that's the way to do it.
I do it once in a while, but that's if like I'm playing the beat off my phone or some shit or whatever.
I feel that. You fuck with any producers? Like, you got a producer that you just go to, or you just everywhere right now?
I mean, I don't produce all my music. I produce some of my music.
Oh, really?
I work in Reason, the program Reason, but for some reason for the last like 8 months, it just has not been working on my computer. But it just depends. Like, I have some people I fuck with that are like dope ass producers. Actually, like one of the dopest, like most slept on producers in San Diego is my cousin, FP the Atlantean.
He does.
He's also like the other half of the league.
Okay.
He makes all of the league's beats. And he's like, we've put out, I mean, at least like 8 tapes in the past like 4 or 5 years. And like, he's just like, he's a beast behind the keys, bro. Like it's unreal. He takes a lot. That thing that like, exactly what I look for in music. Like, he puts an emotion into a beat, so then when you hear it, you're like, you know what type of music or what type of song it should be. You know what I mean?
It takes a lot to be a producer. You gotta have the patience. You just gotta have the right mindset in general to be a producer.
Absolutely. I mean, there's a few other producers. So let me think if I can. I mean, there's so many. Fuck. I know. See, there's some that I can even shout out that I've never even got a beat from. Like, I know Basshead is dope as fuck.
Yeah.
There's a few in San Diego that I know of. I've just never
worked with them.
Worked with them yet. Mm-hmm. Like, I definitely plan to, but a lot of time I'll be on YouTube searching for beats, or like there's a few I fuck with from YouTube that are consistent as fuck with beats.
Yeah. There's there's a lot of big YouTube people who just put hella beats on YouTube and they just, you know, they kill it.
Yeah, absolutely. I've been fucking with DJ Hopper recently.
Really?
Who used to be the DJ for Funk Volume, like Cops and Dizzy Ride and all that. Uh-huh. So the last like 2 songs I've done were produced by him. They actually have a contest. I just dropped a video like on March 14th or something, I believe. Mm-hmm. And it had like a little contest. It was called, his label is called Broken mm-hmm. Complex. It was called like a State of the Union contest. And so I entered that with a video and it was produced by him. And they're actually supposed to say the winner of the contest today. So I keep checking their Facebook page like, bro, you got 2 hours and 30 minutes before it's the next day. So I'm hoping, bro, because the winner gets like 500 bills, $1,000 worth of beats, promotion on their label page and everything. So
that's crazy. That's a good promotion right there.
Yeah,
that's
exactly. Crazy. So fucking hopefully that works out. There was a lot of good competition in that. I was one of the only people who did a video for it, though. I read on the rules.
That'd be different.
Yeah, but I read on the rules and shit afterwards that, like, it doesn't matter if you do a video, we're only judging the song, but it's like, when you're watching the video, like, you can't just ignore it, seeing it, like,
That was
the only
smart
way you can hear the song, you know
that
what I mean, so.
Smart. Good luck to you on that, though.
Huh, good looking.
Bro. But, so who's shooting your video? I know you said you were doing your own videos at one point.
Yeah, well, the last two videos I've put out have been, my homie Jovan Garcia, shout out to my homie. He's been fucking with me for a while now. I actually met him through music. He came to a Dizzy Wright show we did once a long ass time ago, and like we just became friends and we've been fucking with each other ever since. And he's like my photographer, and he'll be at like all the lead shows, photographer and videographer and whatnot. Mm-hmm. He doesn't really do music videos though, so like me and him will go out. We just went out to Julian.
I just seen that.
Yeah, and we'll shoot, and like I'll shoot like B-roll or whatever, mm-hmm. and he'll shoot like clips of me, and then I'll just edit it. So you know what I mean? It's kind of like a joint thing. Okay. Like it's not like I'm doing it all myself or he is.
That's
it's just
you know how
together.
To edit and everything.
You know what I mean? Yeah, I mean, I definitely want to work with some of these like dope ass videographers that like Nick Rodriguez
there's a lot out here in
San
Diego.
Absolutely.
It's crazy.
Yeah, for real. I've shout out to Luke Emmett. He's the same dude who does Ryan Anthony and Ryan Bowers videos. I've done a few videos with him and he's never let me down. Like
Anthony's videos are dope as fuck.
Yeah. Fuck yeah. The one where he's in Europe and shit. That's
crazy.
Super dope. Yeah.
Crazy. I'm trying to get him in here, man. I've been hitting him up.
You sure, bro? I definitely feel like he would come through.
Yeah, I know. Ryan, you gotta fuck with me, bro.
Hell yeah, why not? But there's a lot of dope videographers. I think there's one dude, I don't even know if he's from San Diego. I think he's in between San Diego and LA. His name's Blunt Ass Ziggy, but he makes some fucking hard videos,
bro.
He's made like a few Cali Cams videos. I'm not even sure, but when the first video I saw from him, I was like, damn, like I have to get one done.
Yeah,
for him, you know what I mean?
It's getting crazy. I got to step my shit up, you know, because everybody.
Oh, you do videos too?
Yeah, everybody's getting good, though. It's crazy.
Yeah. Well, yeah, once people realize that, like, you can buy the program, buy the camera, do it yourself, it's like, no one wants to pay someone else anymore. Like, you'd rather just do it.
Work out here.
Yeah, exactly.
So let's talk about the league. How long has that label been going on for?
The league, I mean, I wouldn't say the league is a label. We started out, like, the league actually started before I was even in the league, before I even took rap seriously. So my cousin, FP the Atlantean.
Okay, so you're like the founder.
Nah, I'm not even sure if FP was. I think he was, but I think it's like him and then the other homie, Excel the Phoenix, and then the other homie, Many Ways. His name's Crockett and he lives in Washington. Way back in the day, like when I was, I think it was when I was still in high school, they were doing shit and they were called like Legal Hustle in the league. And then they weren't really putting their shit out that much or like doing shows or promoting themselves like to the extent they could, you know what I mean? And then when I was at NAU for that year, that's when I started doing more music seriously. Cause honestly, bro, I would not say I wasted it, but like money wise going to school and college, I wasted a year completely. Like I played basketball every single day for 6 hours. I went back to the dorm, smoked, wrote music nonstop.
What school did you said you go to?
Northern Arizona University.
How was that?
It was super dope. Like, it was definitely one of the best. It was one of the best years of my life. I mean, it was a dope ass experience.
That was your first year of college?
Mm-hmm. So that's when I, like, my cousin Easton, he was like, he would send me his music and shit. And I'm over here, like, recording in GarageBand with no mic and shit. And I'm, like, hearing his shit. And I'm, like, bro, like, I wasn't very good back then. Like, I don't have talent, but I have skill. Like, I created what I have now. You know what I mean? I wasn't ever just good.
I feel like
he has been just good for so fucking long. Mm-hmm. Like,
just
way back in the day, they were called G-Click. And they were just making like super gangster music, and like that's not even really what I listen to as much, but I'm listening to it, I'm like, holy shit, like, yeah, you know what I mean, they're good as fuck, like they should be doing something with it.
Yeah.
And that's when I decided at NAU, I was like, bro, like, fuck it, I'm about to go back to San Diego, and then I'm about to link up with them and like start doing it seriously. So then I did, I came back, and you then so
have, you couldn't have started anything out there.
No, the thing is, I could have. Now that I'm at the point I am now, like, I wish I would have been more, like, business savvy and, like, music, had more of a music mindset when I was out there, because it's such a small town and, like, everybody knows so many people that, like, it could have been dope.
Yeah, yeah.
I think me and the homies, me and my, two of my best friends, Colin and Nick, we used to rap and we were under, like, the name 3Max, and we did a few little shows out there randomly just at, like, some 18 and up clubs. Like, it wasn't a show, but it was like, oh, you guys want to perform your song? We're like, oh yeah, fuck it, we'll do it. And we're straight. Just like, yeah, fuck it, we'll do it. So definitely, like, yeah, I wish I could have done things differently there, because there's, I definitely could have got like a nice little fan base out there. You
so
know
you
mean?
Just done with school right now? You just, you know.
Yeah, I don't really have time right now, bro. I got to, you know what I mean? Got two jobs right now. You know what I mean? Spend as much time with my daughter and then doing music as well.
How is that? Is it? It's a lot harder now, huh? Now that you know.
Yeah, it is. The I feel like the difference is now I just like need to I prioritize my time better. You know what I mean? And like prioritize what I'm doing, and like not even just like in the month, but like every day. Like I have a list of shit on my phone. I'm clocking shit out every day. Like, all right, I did this, I did this, I did this. Because if I don't, then I'll get caught up in some other shit. Like, oh, well, let me go smoke with this person, or let me go do this, or just I'm just not as like, you know what I mean, on point.
Probably smoking
like
a lot less now, huh?
Oh, absolutely. For real. No, the last like year or 2 years, I've definitely cut back on smoking a lot. Even more so like the last like 4 or 5 months.
Yeah, you got shit to do.
Yeah, and shit, I mean, we cost money, man.
I feel you. That's what I've been on too. Shit, that shit get hella expensive. I might just start buying that shit in bulk.
Huh, for real. Real shit. But yeah, to get back to the label thing. So, long story short, I came back, we started doing music, and it was a group of us, it was like 4 or 5 or 6 of us, and just as time went on, like, me and my cousin just kind of decided, like, we kind of wanted to do our own thing, and like, it used to be called LH The League, which stood for like Legal Hustle The League, and Legal Hustle was the label, and then when we broke off, it was just like, all right, now we're just the League. So the League, the League is like everyone that fucks with us. Like, the League is family, you know what I mean? Like, it's not like the League is just us two, but our group name, the two of us, is called the League. So that's how that became about.
I feel that. Yeah. How is it going so far? You know, you like working with, as a group, you know, with other people?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we've done a lot since we started taking it seriously as like a duo group, as the League. We've done a lot of shows. Like, I'm not even sure how many shows like I could name.
That's crazy.
We've opened Sage of Gemini, Currency, Bone Thugs and Harmony, Hobson, Dizzy Wright, Andre Nicotina, Absol.
Yeah, that's a lot of shows already.
A lot of people Under the Stairs, Clyde Carson. I could keep going. You know what I mean? I forgot some of them.
You just like super comfortable with it now?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, of course, I still get that same feeling. Like, all right, like, let's get it. But it's not really nervousness. It's just like getting in the zone to like go on stage and like try and control the crowd, you know what I mean?
What's because that pregame like? You just, you know.
Well, shit. It changes, bro. It honestly changes, and it changes with the shows too. Cause if it's a more intimate crowd, like we've done some free shows recently. The one in Fullerton at the Slide Bar we just did. It was more of an intimate crowd, and so like I won't really drink. I mean, I'll have a brew or something, and then we'll smoke or whatever, but. Excuse me. Usually when it's a bigger crowd is when it's like, all right, let's, you know what I mean? Yeah. We'll get in a nice zone, smoke a few.
I know artists drink. Get super fucked up before the show.
Bro, I've been there, bro, and it's been, I've only had one experience. It was at UCSD Porter's Pub a while back, and I was actually super drunk. It was like one of our first 10 shows or something. And I made a fool of myself, bro. Like, I knew my words and everything, but after one of our songs, I was so used to people making noise for us after we performed a song. Mm-hmm. So after the song, I'm like, all right, make some noise. And no one said shit, bro. So I'm just like, and I'm faded. And I got angry, bro.
Oh, bro.
I was like, bro, that shit was honestly embarrassing. I went on like a full-on 60-second rant, but I kind of wasn't making sense a lot of time. I'm like, we're over here in San Diego, like, supporting y'all, like, throwing out free shit to y'all, like, y'all can't even make noise, like, how San Diego's supposed to get on, and San Diego people aren't fucking San Diego. Basically just blabbered for, like, a minute straight, and then finally came around and kind of made a point so that I didn't sound that dumb.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then I was just like, all right, DJ, start the next song, and I felt so dumb, bro. The whole song we performed after that, I was embarrassed as fuck. And then right after the song ended, I was like, San Diego, like, can you make a little bit of noise? And they went hard, bro. So it's funny because it worked.
Yeah, it worked out.
But it was super fucking embarrassing. And from that moment, I was like, I'll never be, like, faded like that on stage.
You had that drunk anger.
Yeah, bro. It was really funny. It was even funnier when they went super ham after that. Because it was like, what the fuck? That shit worked. But, yeah, it was definitely embarrassing, bro.
It's usually pretty good turnouts.
Yeah, I mean, I book, like, all of our shows, too. Mm-hmm. So I try and usually... I mean, technically, I don't book them. I get someone to book us, I link with a promoter or whatever. Yeah, but usually try and, like, pick shows that I know are going to be a good turnout. You know what I mean? Like the Lupe show, like that. I went to the Lupe show at House of Blues a few months ago, and I got there, like, 15 minutes late, and then House of Blues was entirely packed from front to back. I couldn't even see. I actually asked some person that was in VIP. I gave them 4 free Hobson tickets to our show if they let me sat in the VIP, and I did. So I got, like, a great seat just last second because that's I just crazy. Offered them some tickets. But
for a Lupe show?
Yeah, bro. Lupe has a fucking strong fan base. Like, I feel like he's definitely more slept on now, I feel like, because just the whole scene is changing in music. You know what I mean? Like, the most popular music is not the... The conscious trap. Lyrical go over your head type shit. It's the trap, turn up, you know what I mean? Just all that. So
that's what the youth wants now. It's crazy. You know, everybody wants to stay turned up.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly. But Lupe's new album, it's dope because he kind of hits on that. It's called Drogas Light. He hits on that because he basically, it's all turn up beats. It's all that style. Uh-huh. And even the way he's rapping, like his flow and shit is... It's on that style, but he's still speaking about dope shit. Yeah. So, like,
I need to listen to it then.
Yeah, you definitely should, bro. It's one of his better albums, too.
I haven't listened to him in a while. I've been sleeping.
Bro, check out Tetsuo and Youth, one of his album before this last one. One of the best albums I've ever heard, hands down. Like, I don't know, bro. He's just so fucking lyrical and so smart. It's like you have to listen to the song like 5 times and you're still not understanding certain shit.
Yeah.
And like, you know what I mean? Not like a challenge. Like, that shit's dope. It's like, so oh, shit. Like,
you just catch new things every time you listen
exactly.
to it. Yeah, exactly. That's good music right there.
Yeah, fuck yeah. Absolutely.
What influenced you to do music?
Damn. That's a great question. I've never really thought about that in depth. I mean... To do music, I think it was just because I've always loved music and, you know what I mean, listening to music and just, like, hearing it and whatever. But I think to start doing it seriously, one of the biggest influencers really was my cousin, because I had never really heard someone that I knew personally that was that good, to where I was like, whoa, like, if he's that good, like, I know him, that's my family, like, maybe if I work hard as fuck, I can get that good. And so, like, I feel like me and him have been on this constant, like, all right, like, watching each other grow, and it makes each other get better, you know what I mean? So it's I definitely say he's been a big part of my influence.
So what's your what social media on right now? All that
Instagram, I mean everything, really. If you want to follow me on Instagram, it's B-Turn with 3 N's, B-T-U-R-N-N-N. And then most of my other shit is The League B-Turn. So, like, Twitter, SoundCloud, all that will be The League B-Turn.
You're pretty consistent on every...
That's one of the things on my little list of shit to do today, or to do every day, is, like, post on all my social media sites, you know what I mean? And, like, sometimes I won't do it every day, but, I'll try and be as persistent as possible. Just because, I mean.
I appreciate you coming out and everything, man.
Absolutely.
I really enjoy your music, you know, because it puts me somewhere where you got to actually listen, and it gives a message to other people, you know. Huh. You know, I feel that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I appreciate it, bro. Definitely fucking. If you want to link up on some shit, just let me know, bro.
Hell yeah. All right, this is my boy B-Turn, man. Everybody go follow him. He's a great artist. Very slept on. Everybody go check him out. You know, he's on SoundCloud, everything. I'm your boy, Papa Smurf. We out.
Smurf Top, boy.
Explain, but you feel it. You felt it your entire life. That there's something wrong with the world. You don't know what it is, but it's there. Like a splinter in your mind.